In my launch day review for the new AMD Radeon RX 9070 and 9070 XT, I talked about the process of making launch day reviews and asked you guys for feedback on whether you like my typical launch day benchmark charts style videos or the recap that I had done several times with the RTX 50 series launch. And people were like, Paul, we really like the recap. So I'm doing another recap.
Excellent.
Today's video is brought to you by Thermaltake's TR100 Mini Tower Case and Travel Trunk. The TR100 is a diminutive but full-featured dual-chamber chassis with a surprisingly roomy interior for high-end PC builds, available in a variety of colors with support for up to 360mm GPUs and a 280mm AIO radiator on top. The modular design means side panels are all removable for cable management, and upgrades include an optional LCD panel or the travel trunk to easily take your TR100 gaming PC setup on the go. For more on the TR100 Mini Tower Case from Thermaltake, check out my build or click the sponsor link in the video description. So I'm going to be recapping 6 launch day video reviews. They're all linked in the description. They're from Hardware Unboxed, Gamers Nexus, J's Two Cents, Linus Tech Tips, Optimum, and Kit Guru. Some of these reviews covered the 9070 and 9070 XT like I did in mine, and some just covered the 9070 XT, although all of them were drawing comparisons to NVIDIA's cards, most specifically the RTX 5070, but alongside that, the RTX 5070 Ti. And while the RX 9070 and 9070 XT don't go up for sale until tomorrow, the 5070 actually went up for sale today, so let's take a look, and they're gone. Well, that was a pretty easy prediction to make. The RTX 5070s all selling out within a few minutes of them going up for sale, making all of us reviewers pretty much liars for actually comparing that card at a $550 MSRP. They're probably going to be going for more than that, at least in the near future. Early rumors about stock and supply for the 9000 series have been a little bit more optimistic because these have apparently been arriving at retailers as early as like January or even late December 2024. But that still lies in the realm of speculation. We won't find out more about that until tomorrow. Let's stick to stuff that we can verify by going over the benchmark results, starting with rasterization performance. We're looking at Hardware Unboxed results from their 18-game benchmark suite. Steve found that at 1440, the 9070 XT is 6% slower than the 5070 Ti, but is 13% faster than the 5070. Not a bad win there, and Steve only showed the 9070 XT results in his first video. At 4K though, the gap closed and the 9070 XT was only 1% slower than the 5070 Ti, while remaining 23% faster than the 5070. Taking a look at Gamers Nexus results next, they ran 10 games for rasterization performance. At 4K, Steve and crew found the 9070 XT beats the 5070 Ti in 3 of their titles, however it's typically 5-10% slower in the remaining games. At 1440, the 9070 XT matches or beats the 5070 Ti in 5 titles, and then it's 3-34% slower otherwise. Again, this is compared to the 5070 Ti, which is theoretically $750 compared to $600 for the 9070 XT, although 5070 Ti is actually way more expensive than that right now. And then there are some outliers with Final Fantasy and Black Myth Wukong, where NVIDIA still maintains a pretty significant lead. Next, results from Linus Tech Tips. They tested 6 games. At 1440, the 9070 XT was 13% faster than the 9070 and 21.5% faster than the 5070. At 4K, the 9070 XT was 13.7% faster than the 9070 and 24.5% faster than the 5070. The next results are from Optimum. He tested 11 games and found that at 1440, the 9070 was 3% faster than an RTX 5070, whereas the 9070 XT was 5% slower than a 5070 Ti, although it was 15% faster than an RTX 5070. Next results are from Kit Guru, who tested 12 games. At 1440, they found the 9070 XT to be 30% faster than the 5070, 6.2% faster than the 5070 Ti, and 13.6% faster than the 9070, while at 4K, the 9070 XT was 33.6% faster than a 5070, 5.5% faster than a 5070 Ti, and 15% faster than a 9070. So to sum up these rasterization numbers, the $600 9070 XT can often keep up with the $750 to $1,000 plus, depending on the street prices right now, 5070 Ti or 4080 Super, since those two cards are pretty equivalent, with different reviewers finding about a 5% variance either way. It's also 13-15% faster than the 9070 and is usually just a few percentage points behind the last gen flagship 7900XTX. The 9070 non-XT is typically 5-10% faster than the RTX 5070 in pure rasterization performance as well. But you know what? It's 2025 and ray tracing is a thing. I just rolled all the ray tracing results in into my final numbers in my video, but let's take a look at some separated ray tracing results, starting with Hardware Unboxed again, who ran 6 games for ray tracing. At 1440, the 9070 XT was 21% slower than the 5070 Ti in Steve's tests, while it was also 3% slower than the 5070. While ray tracing performance is improved with the 9000 series cards, as you can see, the 26% improvement over the 7900 XTX is pretty significant. The NVIDIA RTX series cards still have a little bit of an edge here. At 4K, the 9070 XT was 25% slower than the 5070 XT and 2.5% slower than the 5070, while it was 27% faster than the 7900 XTX. The Linus Tech Tips ray tracing tests showed similar results. At 1440, the 9070 XT was 2% slower than the 5070 for them, while the 9070 non-XT was 17% slower than the 5070. The 9070 matches the 7900 XTX performance-wise here, while the 9070 XT is 17.5% faster. KitGuru ran 8 ray tracing specific games. At 1440, they found the 9070 XT to be 15% slower than the 5070 Ti, 9.5% faster than the 5070, and 11.4% faster than the last generation flagship 7900 XTX. So with these results, we can see that ray tracing performance is much improved versus last gen for AMD, going from the 7000 series to the 9000 series. AMD still trails NVIDIA here, but that gap has closed significantly, and ray tracing performance, I think it's safe to say, is no longer a massive NVIDIA advantage slash Radeon detractor. A few other notes that I noted while going through these reviews, Jay, as well as several others, noted the 1% lows or frame time consistency was often better with AMD's 9070 and 9070 XT. For example, in this F1 2024 graph, you can see the 5070 having many spikes and jitters versus the much smoother results for the 9070 and 9070 XT. 1% lows in many charts have shown AMD to have an advantage for this generation. Several reviews also focused on what is perceived as the 5070's biggest shortcoming, the 12GB VRAM buffer, I guess perhaps only second to its availability. Lots of people have complained about the 5070 only having 12 gigs of VRAM for $550 in 2025, $550 theoretically. And the nice thing is, we don't have to wait for some theoretical future game to show how a 12GB VRAM buffer can hurt your performance. Linus Tech Tips showed that while testing The Last of Us at 4K, their 5070 ran out of VRAM, resulting in crazy frame time spikes with the 5070 versus the 9070. When all your VRAM gets used up, performance tanks, but those spikes go away when testing with 16GB cards. Likewise, Hardware Unboxed showed that Indiana Jones and the Great Circle, when maxed out with ray tracing performance and everything, can put a serious damper on the performance of cards that have 12 gigs of VRAM or less. Steve heavily criticized NVIDIA in his 5070 review using this demo, and then further demonstrated the value of having more VRAM today. Cards with a 12 gig VRAM limit simply can't run this game at 4K using these maxed out settings. Now granted, the 9070 XT's 7 FPS at 4K or 17 FPS at 1440 isn't exactly ideal, but it is infinity percent better than the 5070's 0 FPS. Let's talk power draw and temperatures next. Over at Hardware Unboxed, Steve tested 5 9070 XT variants side by side, showing that all of these third-party designs can achieve excellent cooling with these GPUs. They were in the mid-50s or low 60s Celsius, and hotspots were in the mid-80s for the most part, while frequencies were in the 3100 to 3200 megahertz range. As I noted in my review, memory temperatures can be a bit high on the 9070 and 9070 XT, but are still reasonable at 85 to 90C. Jay's Two Cents did some power draw testing under stress tests with Furmark, the overclocked XFX Mercury Mag Air 9070 XT, which is one of those 340 watt higher TDP models, did hit 350 watts of power draw, while the standard 9070 was running at about 230 watts and the 5070 Ti hit 310 watts. KitGuru found a non-overclocked 9070 XT model to draw a more typical 320 watts across their 1440 tests, with the 9070 coming in at 218.9 watts. And while the power draw with these cards does look a bit higher relative to NVIDIA cards, when balanced with performance, as shown in Gamers Nexus's frames per second per watt chart, the 9070 XT actually aligns very closely with the RTX 5070 in terms of efficiency, with the performance boost balancing the increased power consumption. This is another area where NVIDIA has typically had a lead in the past, but that lead has apparently evaporated, or at least the gap has closed significantly, much like it has with ray tracing. Upscaling is another area that AMD needs to gain ground on NVIDIA's DLSS with FSR4. FSR4 is now machine learning enhanced, which on the downside means the latest features only work with the RX 9000 series GPUs, but on the plus side, it's a Huge improvement over FSR 3.1 per Dominic from KitGuru. Side-by-side comparisons in Ratchet and Clank show notably better upscaling precision for things like confetti drifting down or semi-transparent objects not being a muddled mess. And just overall precision, detail, and accuracy have vastly improved with FSR 4. Even when compared side-by-side with DLSS 4, which is one of the few things that NVIDIA got generally good feedback on with the 50 series launch, the FSR 4 upscaling holds up, and it's pretty tough to tell the difference. That's not to say it's perfect. There are still artifacts to be seen, particularly when video capture is zoomed in and slowed down, but per LTT, when upscaling to 4K, the image quality of FSR is no more distracting than DLSS 4. It's also noteworthy that AMD has Frame Gen 2. Single frame gen, not multi-frame gen, but it actually seems to work a bit better than NVIDIA, which is pretty funny, though it's using FSR 3.1's frame gen implementation, which apparently has pretty low overhead. The main complaints about FSR 4, though, will likely be game support. DLSS 4 has much wider adoption right now, even when including FSR 3 titles that can be forced into FSR 4 mode, and AMD's Fluid Motion Frames backup driver level solution for frame generation is still very underwhelming and isn't even worth turning on based on how awful the image quality is. If there's one area the new 9070 and 9070 XT truly fall short right now, it's the other thing you can do besides gaming with a GPU. Productivity. Ollie from Optimum tried to use the special beta version of Blender that AMD distributed for reviews, and he wasn't even able to get it to work. The 9000 series cards are better at Blender, but they still fall short of NVIDIA's offerings. LTT ran several Underwriters Laboratory benchmarks showing AI workloads have improved with the 9000 series though, versus the 7000 series, but again, they're still falling short versus NVIDIA's offerings, especially when compared to how those gaming charts lined up. Fortunately, content creation tests still show AMD keeping up reasonably well in stuff like the Adobe Suite, but H.264 encoding is also behind both Intel and NVIDIA in terms of image quality. So that pretty much sums up the reviews that I'm rounding up today, and the general vibe for the 9070 and 9070 XT debut has been quite positive, although not without a good amount of caveats and if-then statements. As shown by cost per frame charts, including mine, the 9070 XT is the best value we currently have available in the mid-range to high-end, and while that's good news, AMD is also greatly benefiting from a lack of competition in this space. The fact that there are pretty much no last-gen cards still available to buy means options are slim to none if you decide the 9070 or 9070 XT don't exactly meet your requirements. Your options then become an even poorer value NVIDIA 5070 or 5070 Ti that is probably grossly overpriced even beyond its disappointing MSRP if you can even find one available for sale thanks to lack of availability, or I suppose just don't be a PC gamer. Go outside, touch grass and stuff. And after a very long gauntlet of GPU launches in Q1, I think that's what I'm going to do. So thank you guys for watching this video, and a reminder that all of these detailed reviews are linked in the video description if you'd like to watch them in full. Also, you can check out my store at paulshardware.net if you'd like to buy some high quality merchandise to help support my channel. And of course, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe if you're not already if you'd like to see more tech videos like this one in the future. Thanks again for watching, guys. I'm so glad that we're through all these launches. We'll see you all in the next video.